Hey, if you're anything like me when I'm playing on a Minecraft server, I love to look for things that make the experience exciting and immersive. If you are also like this, or you think that your players on your Minecraft server think like this, then proximity chat is the quick and easy solution to engaging your players on your server, and in today's video, I'll be showing you how to add it to your Minecraft server using an easy to understand plugin called Skoice. If you get lost at any point throughout today's video, you can either join my Discord server, Skoice's Discord server, or you could check out the text tutorial located over on my website linked in the video description. With all of that out of the way, we can begin this tutorial by navigating to the first link in the video description. You'll be taken to a page that looks something like this. You'll want to download this plugin by pressing on the download button right here, and make sure you save your download. Next, navigate over to your Minecraft server's file manager. From here, you'll want to open your server's plugins folder, and then upload your newly downloaded plugin into this folder. After the plugin finishes uploading, restart your Minecraft server. Now that you've installed the plugin, you'll want to navigate over to the second link in the video description. You'll be taken over to Discord's developer portal. From here, you'll want to ensure that you're logged into the correct Discord account, and if you are, press on New Application right over here. After pressing on that, you'll need to enter an application name, and then press on Create right here. Next, you're going to want to press on the bot option right over here, and then you need to press on Add Bot right over here, and finally, press on Yes to create your bot. After you successfully complete your bot setup, you can customize the bot's name and profile picture here. I'll leave mine as the default for now, however, I'd suggest customizing this if you are using this on a public server. After you've customized your Discord bot, scroll down until you see Privileged Gateway Indents, which is basically just a fancy way of saying what your bot can and cannot access. You're going to need to turn all of these indents on just to ensure compatibility. Once you are done, make sure you save your changes right here. Now that all of your permissions have been set up, it's time to invite your Discord bot to your Discord server. Press on the OAuth 2 button on the side over here, and then press on URL Generator. From here, you're going to press on the bot button right here in the middle, and then administrator. Then you're going to want to copy this link at the bottom. After you've copied this link, open a new tab and paste the link in there. Once this web page loads, you're going to need to select the server that you will be adding proximity chat to, and then press continue. Finally, press authorize. If this was successful, you will now be able to see your Discord bot, albeit offline, inside of your Discord server. Now that we've got this Discord bot into your server, it's time to do a bit of setup for your Discord server. The first thing that we will need to do is to create a voice chat for people to join proximity chat. I'm going to name mine proximity chat. And then I'm going to create it like this. You're also going to need to create a category for the different voice chats that the Skoice plugin will create for people within different ranges of one another. I'm going to create my category right here, and I'm just going to name this Skoice. Also, make sure that your proximity chat voice chat is within this category here, or else this will not work. Now, the first thing that we need to configure your plugin is your Discord bot's token. Navigate back to Discord's developer portal and open up your application. From here, you're going to need to navigate to the bot tab and press on Reset Token. If you have two-factor authentication enabled, you'll need to enter a 2FA code to regenerate this token. Once your token is regenerated, press on Copy to copy the token. Please make sure that you store this somewhere secure, as anybody who has access to this token has full access to your Discord bot. Another thing that goes alongside this is resetting your Discord bot's token. If you reset your Discord bot's token after the setup, you will need to go through the whole Skoice setup all over again, so make sure you don't do that. Now that you've copied the token, navigate back to your Minecraft server and run the command /skoice-token and then paste your token right here. Then, once you run the command, you'll see this success message that does take a second to load, and now we're going to need to navigate over to our Discord server to finish configuring the plugin. Now that we are over in the Discord server, we will need to run the command /configure to configure the Skoice plugin. If you are in multiple servers, the Discord bot will first ask you to select which Discord server you'd like to use Skoice in, and it will leave all of the other servers. But if your Discord bot is not in multiple servers, you will not see this, and instead, it will just ask you which voice chat you would like to use Skoice with. Select the voice chat you selected earlier, and once you do this, the bot will immediately move on to the proximity chat mode. For this, you can select whatever is best for your server, however, I'm going to select vanilla. After you've selected those two things, your proximity chat plugin should be all configured now. press on close to close out this embed. However, if you want to do more advanced configuration, you can do so within that embed. However, even though the plugin configuration is done, that does not mean that the setup process is complete. Now you will need to link your Discord account and Minecraft accounts using the /link command. I'll give an example on how to do this. Before you begin, ensure that you are logged into the Minecraft server with Skoice on it. Then run the /link command in your Discord server to generate a unique code for your Minecraft server. Copy this command right over here, and then navigate over to your game and paste that code in your game. If you do this properly, your Discord and Minecraft accounts will be linked and you will be able to successfully use proximity chat. Please note that every single person that wants to use proximity chat will have to link their accounts. So if you're running a public server with this plugin, it may be best to give a bit of a tutorial to your players. But with all of that out of the way, that wraps up this video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.